You have to walk when you wear them like that. Anyway, I just want to say a great big ha! Yeah, yeah. You, I know, but anyway, it's a beautiful day today. Okay, I want to right now introduce to you the biggest and meanest dog in the United States, old Walter himself. Here he comes. So here he is, Black Tooth, you old sweetheart. Don't kid. Oh, listen, I got to show this picture because we've been making fun of it. Right here it is. Oh, yeah. We've been talking about Skinny Hoey, Gene, our assistant producer, and, like, people getting bugged. What does he look like? Because they know what the other guys look like. They find out they go down to police lineup on Monday morning. But Gene just joined us. Here he is. He's an amateur flyer. You son of a gun, Gene. Those pictures don't do you justice. You're singing like that. I mean, where'd you learn to sing like that?
At my speech class. That's right, Bobby.
At your speech? Who's your teacher?
Al Kelly. It's no laughing matter.
Oh, yeah.
That's right. You see, You see, Booby?
Yeah?
All us great actors have to have good speech to perform our craft.
Yeah?
That's right.
And Al Kelly teaches you this?
Undoubtedly.
Yes, like what?
Well, he has very good techniques for teaching voice and diction, you know.
Yeah, like what?
Well, first in the class, he takes his students and he x-rays the vocal veins.
He x-rays the vocal veins?
That's right.
Yeah.
And then after he's finished with that, he examines your esophagus, see?
Yeah.
To see that it's in the right place.
Yeah.
Yeah. And then after that, he exercises the cleavage. That's right.
Is anyone near the drain?
That's right. How'd you know, Bibby?
I know.
You've been taking lessons too, huh?
Well, years ago.
Oh.
I make enemies at Dale Carnegie classes. Yeah, go ahead.
Well, anyway, after he x-rays your vocal vein and your esophagus and the claimant, he teaches you to get a clear hair shape until everything comes out smoothing. That's right.
Yeah?
And that's where I learned to speak so fluently.
Yeah.
Oh, speak the speech, I pray you, and let it flow drippingly off the tongue. Whee! And then...
Yeah.
That's not all.
Yeah?
It's followed by lesson number two.
What's lesson number two?
Well, Booby...
Yeah?
First, you fill up your mouth with marbles.
Yeah?
Then, after every lesson...
Yeah?
You take out one of your marbles.
Yeah?
And then... After you've lost all your marbles, you're an actor.
Yes, thanks. And that's a good school.
Right. Well, and if you don't have any marbles, you can use bonbons.
Oh, didn't he used to sing with Jan Savage? Didn't it? No, anyway, what?
Booby,
tell me that the Pookie players are in town?
That's right, Booby. But tell me one thing.
What?
Are you sure you took off that rubber nose?
Oh, come on.
The Pookie players are in town, and we're going to stay in town as long as the people keep coming to the theater.
Just passing through, huh? Listen, how is this new play?
Oh, Booby, I tell you, it's a great play.
Yeah.
It's a great play. Your brains are full out.
Yeah.
It's a surefire winner.
What do you mean?
Well, you see, we took the lyrics from an Anthony Newley hit,
yeah.
And then we took the book from an Abe Burrows hit,
yeah.
The production from a Dave Merrick hit,
yeah.
And we took the choreography from Golden Boy.
What'd you get?
60 days and a fine of $10,000 for plagiarism.
Yeah, you can't do that.
No, but we found that out the hard way, Booby.
What do you mean?
But you know,
yeah.
You know what, Booby?
Yeah.
We feel in our bones it's going to be a big hit.
Yeah.
You know what?
What?
We played it in Washington.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
A command performance?
We gave a command performance for the president.
Uh-huh. Well, what'd they say after the play?
Well, he didn't wait until after the play. He commanded us to stop before we got started.
Yeah. Well, somebody liked it.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I was going to tell you. The president of the ASPCA, he got up and he raved.
Oh, why?
He thought it was the biggest dog he'd ever seen.
Yeah. Well, listen, oh, that must be wonderful. Well, is that what you're going to... How about I talk and his mouth moves?
Are you sure that's your real nose, Booby?
Wouldn't it be funny if I was the dummy?
What do you mean, wouldn't it be funny? He's not kidding, folks.
How do you do, Mr. Wright? Guy said the customer's always right.
That's true. This is my little boy.
Oh, yes?
Hey, do you have seafood?
We sell anything that swims.
Okay, bring me Esther Williams.
Sit down.
Anything that swims, and my little boy said bring me Esther Williams. He's pretty funny. He's a war baby.
Yeah, a face like that make anybody fight. Sit down here.
Thank you, sir.
That's all right. Yeah.
What can I do for you?
Well, let's see. I feel that you insulted me on the way in. My little boy is handsome, as you can see, just like his father. Women chase me down the street.
What do you do, steal their pocketbooks? Don't give me that jazz. What is it?
Not water?
A little water would certainly be in tune.
Yeah,
that's... Daddy, you got a light.
Son, that is not a cigar.
Cigar,
C-I-G-A-R.
Cigar. Oh, shut up.
Shut up. S-H-U-T-U-P. Shut up.
What spells beautifully.
Yeah?
Last time I'll ever take one of these spells anymore, I tell you.
Yeah, welcome, gentlemen.
Say.
Yes.
That's the rudest hat check girl I ever did meet in my whole life. We came in, gave her our hats and coats, and I also gave her a Picasso. She didn't even give me a claim check.
What check girl?
That check girl.
We don't have a check girl.
I gotta call the police.
Oh, wait a minute. Just settle. I'll take care of it. Hey, honey, we got a sore head here. Bring it back. Yeah. Next time, try jellies. Yeah, okay. Okay, gents. I'll get you some water.
Listen, you know, you're picking on me all the way down here. You know, when we had the last sneak preview of On Rise Express, the audience cheered and whistled and hollered.
What happened? Did the reel break?
The reel break. Hey,
that's really funny. No, the reel didn't break. Because I saved two girls in the picture.
Yeah, one for the producer and one for himself. You know, this cat never splits nothing.
Thank you.
It's a Cleary. Now, let's find out what we want to eat.
Yeah, what?
Is there any soup in the menu?
Yeah, but we wiped it off. Say, do you serve women in this restaurant?
We certainly do.
Well, bring me a long, tall, cool blonde, will you?
No, seriously, I would like to have some frog's legs. Would you bring me some frog's legs?
Frog's legs, right. Yeah. How about you?
How's your egg foo young?
Well, it's not egg, it's not young, it's just foo.
I'll get it for you. No, this is not
Did
a
you
bad
want
place.
Something,
this
sir?
This is not a bad place.
You want to start off with a salad?
Yeah, give me a little salad.
Okay.
Even come to think of it, you bring us into some pretty wild places. What do you think of this place?
Well, it's not too bad. I think a little needs a little little band, maybe a little fire.
here's your frog legs.
Hee-haw, hee-haw, hold it. One of these frog legs are shorter than the other.
What do you want, buddy? You want to eat it or dance with it?
You get smart with me.
Here's your salad.
How about some Italian dressing?
Okay.
And you make, if you want to, you just go right over and ask.
Put your coat on. How do you like that for Italian dressing?
P.I., you'll love the coffee and the milk and the pie.
Okay, Daddy.
Okay. Just come.
P.I.E.
The service is rather slow.
Oh, yes, slow, sir.
There you go.
Pie. You hit my son with a pie.
P.I.E.
Did you? You're the one that had your feet out there in the aisle?
Did I have my feet in the aisle?
Yeah.
Hey! Hey, you can't do this!
What is this?
You hit my daddy with a pie!
Oh, I'm sorry, kid. Yeah. Just a second.
Okay, your second's up.
Put your hands out.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, you just...
Do you know that you hit my son with a pie?
Hey!
Just a minute.
Hey, what is this?
What is this?
Well, hey, what's this right here?
How dare you throw pies around?
A thousand pardons, and that's two more than my uncle got. They came in, see, and you guys were eating here, and I went over there, and he ordered pie.
Boy, I'd never come to this joint again. I'd like to see somebody do that to one of us.
Well, wait a minute. There were three of you, and there's two of him. He's the one that brought the kid.
Wait a minute! I was sitting here with my daddy, and we ordered pie, and he comes in and he goes, pie! He's like that! And I went, why?
Now wait just a moment!
And I was just minding my own business, and all that money comes in the pot, and my daddy tried to...
Did you do that
to him.
No, I mean, I was...
Now, wait a minute. I was trying to take good care of you.
Just a moment.
Hey, you can't do that to my leader.
Here's your leader.
No, there's your leader.
Wait a moment. What is going on here? You must have police.
I'll tell you what happened, sir. I was waiting on the tables, and Johnny Downs, they're celebrities. Johnny Downs and Wilt Chamberlain and Cesar Romero walked in here. See, I knew they were celebrities in the show business. And this little kid come here, and he hit him with a pie, see? Yeah, like this. Show him, sir.
Oh! Please!
Hang, there are a lot of dances, right?
Yeah.
There's the lobster. There is the Indian. There's the recorder. Get a grip on it. Yeah. You can't get a suitcase, but anyway, we're gonna do the old mouth.
Mother!
mother.
Your ex-mother. Ow, ow, ow.
Hours under the car with your dad?
Yeah.
Fixing it?
No, hiding from bill collectors. My daddy never pays his bills.
Yeah.
Hey, Soupy.
Yeah.
I was wondering.
Come on in. Come on in.
No, I can't. I'm in a hurry. I was wondering if you wanted to go to the neighborhood play tonight.
Yeah.
Because I'm selling tickets.
Are you kidding him? I'm going. I certainly am. I have two seats.
Does Ripley know about this? You get it?
Gee, that's a pretty watch you have there.
Oh, this watch has been in my family for generations.
It must be an heirloom.
No, it's a Timex.
Are you trying to make a fool out of me?
No, nature beat me to it. I'll see you around, Soupy. Bye.
Thanks for being with us. Bye-bye. We'll see you tomorrow.
Oh, wait, Aunt.
Yes, sir?
I would like to have a bowl of soup.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Here you are, sir. I hope you enjoy.
Waiter?
Yes, sir?
There's a fly in my soup.
How much can a fly eat?
Waiter!
Yes, sir?
There's a fly in my soup!
Don't worry, the heat'll kill him.
Waiter.
Yes, sir?
There's a fly in my soup.
We've been looking for him all day.
Waiter.
Yes, sir?
There's a fly in my soup.
I know, we ran out of hummingbirds.
Waiter.
Yes, sir?
There's a fly in my soup.
That's all right. Our chef used to be a tailor.
Waiter!
Yes?
There's a fly in my soup!
What do you expect for 15 cents, Mark Spitz?
Waiter.
Yes, sir?
There's a fly in my soup.
Shh, not so loud. Everybody will want one.
Waiter.
Yes, sir?
There's a fly in my soup.
He belongs to that guy over there.
No.
Take it anyway.
Waiter.
Yes, sir?
How many of these have we done?
Eight.
Eight is enough.
I'm excited about? Uh-huh. I'll tell you what I'm excited about. A little while ago, I was in the backyard, uh-huh. and all of a sudden, I heard some singing. What? And it wasn't like a normal voice. It was like a little voice, see? Yeah. And I looked down, and there's a singing bug. That's right, playing a piano. Yeah. I brought him inside. That's him. That's him. Listen to him. Buggy, sing something for Black Dude. Isn't that something? I told you. Now listen to this. Uh-huh. I know Alice Cooper, see? Uh-huh. And he's getting ready to go out on tour all over the United States, see? And he needs an opening act. Uh-huh. And I figure we could make a lot of money, you know, because Alice works with the spiders and snakes uh-huh. and the scorpions, you know, and catamarans and things like that, see? Yeah. And I figure, well, he would be a great opening act. Yeah. Yeah. That's right. So I call Alice. He's in rehearsal now for the big show. Uh-huh. So he said he'd stop by. And this... Oh, Alice, come in, come in.
Come on, wait till my rehearsal. And, you know, you call me up and everything.
I know that, Alice. I got something great to tell you.
You're getting out of showbiz.
No, no.
Oh, you're going to stay in showbiz.
Alice, listen, listen to me. I've got a bug.
Oh, don't breathe on me. Don't breathe on me. It's awful.
No, come on now. Come on. Now, listen, I found a singing bug right over here. Yeah, you won't believe it. Out in the backyard. Now, you're getting ready to go on tour, see?
Yeah.
You'll need an opening act, right? And everything like that. Listen, Buggy, here's Alice Cooper. Do a number for him. About that.
That's the best thing I've ever seen him. I've got to have that bug in my show.
Okay.
He's got to open. I got a contract right here.
He's got a contract.
52 weeks, $10,000. That's a lot of money.
It sure $10,000
$10,000. That's a lot of sign. To weeks? Sign before right you there. Think of
oh,
it.
Oh, hi, White Fang. Listen, you know Alice Cooper.
Yeah, hi, White Fang. Listen, did you see that bug? Listen, White Fang.
Yeah?
Why don't you come on down to the rehearsal studio with me?
You want White Fang to go to rehearsal hall with you and sing with your group?
Yeah?
No. I want him to come down there and kill bugs. You see, we get places loaded with them.
Oh, yeah!
Does that mean our contract is null and void?
Yes, I'm coming. I'm going. There's my favorite dog, the biggest and sweetest dog in the whole United States, Black Tooth. I know. Don't kiss. I know that. Listen, I'm going to do the $20,000 pyramid today. And that's right, with Dick Clark, yeah. And I'm going down to the studio, and I'll be back about 4:30. Now, what I want you to do is, I want you, if you go outside, be sure and lock the door, okay? And that's right. And White Fang, if you see him, tell him before he comes in the house to be sure and wipe his paws. I don't know about his maws, just his paws. Yeah, all right? That might be the phone. It is the phone. You thought it was your ears?
Hello?
Hello, this is the $20,000 pyramid calling for a Mr. Key. Would you tell him to come to the $20,000 pyramid show this afternoon at 1 o'clock to be on our show?
Mr. Key?
Yeah, this is Pooh Key's residence, isn't it?
Yes, sir, I'll tell him.
Yes, thank you.
How about that? Pookie's gonna be on a $20,000 pyramid. Hey, Pook! Hey, Pook!
Hey, Booby!
There he is. Mm-hmm. How are you? Listen, I just got a phone message for you to report this afternoon to play the $20,000 pyramid.
Hey, that's great.
Yeah.
Oh, I hope I get a good celebrity guest to play opposite. Somebody like Joanne Worley or Bill Cullen.
Well, what about Soupy Sales?
What about him?
Well, he's a good player. They say he's one of the best.
Who said it?
I'm doing the show today. Also, Boot, we might just get each other. And I know the game backwards and forwards. It's the greatest, and Dick Clark's going to love you.
Oh, the kissing disease.
Mononucleosis.
Yeah, the Liberty Bell, eggs, safes, your head.
Things are cracked.
Yeah.
Listen, I'd horsewhip you if I had a horse. Listen, I'll see you down at the studio.
Okay.
A lot of players think it's bad luck if I don't give the person in this chair a little rub.
Yeah, I know that. I know a masseur who got fired yesterday. He rubbed a customer the wrong way. It's jokes have kept me out of big time for years.
You're incorrigible. Pooh, don't let that scare you. Really, he is one of our best players.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, he really is. Now, you do know the rules.
Yeah.
You can't use your hands. Well, I guess that's,
I wish I was Italian so I had hands.
All right, knock it off.
All right, now, you guys ready?
Yes, yes. Right,
stand by. Here is your first category. Go.
I'm the waterfront. Streetcar Named Desire.
Elia Kazan movies.
No. The Men.
The Men. Army Pictures.
The Young Lion.
The Zoo Pictures.
Go to the next one. Elm, Maple, Oak.
Famous Lawyers.
Pine, Weeping Willow.
Pine, Weeping Willow. Streets in Pittsburgh.
No. Eucalyptus, Maple. Go to the next one.
Yeah.
I had 100 legs and they go clap, 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 clap.
50 horses.
50 horses? 50. No. Yeah. I'm lying and slimy and I slither along.
An agent.
No. I clip, clap, clip, clap. I got all these legs.
A bunch of horses.
No. Go to the next one. Ellen Burst and Joan Fontaine, Jane Fonda.
The Supremes.
Olivia de Havilland.
Yeah.
Olivia de Havilland.
Charlie's Angels, the girl on the Charlie's Angels.
Go to the next one.
Oh.
Okay. As time goes by.
Yes. Oh, yes. What the editors of Newsweek say.
No.
What the guys.
Play it again, Sam.
Yeah. A Sammy Davis song.
No. You must remember this.
Oh, Pearl Harbor and the Alamo. The Alamo.
Go to the next one.
Yes, go.
Okay. De Niro, Peso, a Buck.
A Famous Vaudeville Teams.
No. A Finn, a Moolah.
The Ames Brothers.
The Ames Brothers? No.
Famous Trios. Oh, you know, listen, I guess we lost it.
Where do you get that wee stuff?
Well, all I know is I...
Where did you get that pie?
The same place you got this dummy.
Listen, do you think there's a chance of us coming on American Bandstand? Hey, Walker, once again. Right now, let's go to the words of wisdom. They're very important, and we want you to pay close attention to them, and they go like this. A used car isn't always what it's jacked up to be. Now, what do we mean by that?
Yeah, what do we mean by that?
Well, I'm going to tell you. I mean that buying a secondhand automobile can be a very tricky thing. Many a big wheel has had a used car salesman give him a bum steer. Because those guys really know how to overhaul your bank account. They'll use every old Dodge in the world to get you to put a down payment on a jalopy that you can't afford. And when you come back the next day, you find they flew the coop. Well, I think it's high time that the Buick stopped here. We've got to start moving our taillights and get all of those hoods to retire.
Let's tell every shady used car dealer to make sure his chassis are really classy, or else we're going to tune up, turn around, and leave them flat. Now, let's not wait till the Mercury goes down, or Plymouth rocks, or Datsun sets. Well, that's the way the Mercedes-Benz. And if you do that, then write in and explain to me what I've been talking about. I don't know, but let's look at it this way. Okay, now.
Gray skies are gonna clear up.
Put on a happy face.
Oh, okay. Is this happy enough for you?
Yeah, it's happy enough.
Ooh!
But I don't understand what you're doing.
Well, I have the face of a duck in the body of a lion. Who am I?
My agent. Oh, no, I just...
Close, but wrong.
Yeah?
I'm actually doing an impression of one of my favorite performers.
I give up. Who?
Duck Van Dyke.
Oh, I bet... Is it that time?
I think it is, and it better be.
Listen. Well, I love you anyway.
Hit it, Dave.
Oh, the Pookie Theater. The Pookie Theater presents... The Pookie Players.
Yeah.
The Judge. Oh, yes. I know. I used to be an honor student. Yes, Your Honor. No, Your Honor. So, okay. I'll see you next month. Oh, this is going to be classic. Oh, here comes the judge. Here comes the judge.
Court is now in session. Will the first case step forward?
Your Honor, I appeal to you.
No, you don't. Order in the court.
Okay, I'll have a ham on rye and a big orange drink.
Young man, have you ever been up before me?
I don't know, Your Honor. What time do you get up? Clarence Darrow, 1926.
State your case.
Oh, well, it's my wife. She left me. Only thing she didn't take from the house was this girdle. And I'm keeping it.
Why, what's she suing you for?
Non-support.
Put him under the jail.
Well, you want to know something? Listen, that was good.
Oh, yeah, thank you, Booby.
Yeah.
By the way, I'm starting a new job today.
What's that? What happened to your new job? What happened to your job at the ice cream store?
I was fired.
You were fired from your job at the ice cream store?
Yeah.
Why?
I came down with a bad case of the shakes.
That's my doggy White Fang. Hi, doggy.
Oh,
yeah. Where are you going? Going out to eat.
Oh, yeah.
What?
Well,
Pickens around here getting slim?
Yeah.
He's one of my favorite actors, Slim Pickens. Yeah. Wait a minute. Come here. Just a second. Where are you going to eat? Place down the street sells chicken dinners for a quarter?
Uh-huh.
Yeah. It's a feed store.
Uh-huh. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Well,
Come on. Wait a minute. Now, wait a minute. You're going to go down there. You're going to miss. You don't have to go out tonight. Yes, you do. No, you don't. Well, because if you don't, we're going to be short 3 minutes.
No.
Now, listen, you don't have to eat out tonight. No. All you got to do is just whistle and enjoy Soupy's gourmet delight. That's right. Yeah, what is that? That's right. And that sign is true. If we don't have it, we pay you $100.
That's right.
Yeah. Oh, yes, sir. Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's right. Just like Mom used to cook.
Oh, what?
Let me get this thing, Lance. That's a cap.
Okay.
What would you like? You got me what? Get ready to hand over the $100 for what? A gorilla kneecap sandwich. Just a minute, I gotta go down and check the kitchen. I'll be right back. There you go, a gorilla kneecap sandwich.
Oh, yeah?
That's right. That'll be a dollar. Yes, sir.
That's right.
Not too good? You got me what? Hand it over. You don't hand no money over. If we can't fill the order, you get $100. Yeah, what is it? You want some souffled hippopotamus lips? Just a moment. Let me check down in the kitchen. Here you go. Souffled hippopotamus lips. Give me the money. That's right. I said it was like Mom used to make. Well, my mom's a terrible cook. You got the money? You want an elephant ear sandwich? Give it a money. Wait a minute. Let me check the kitchen. Just a moment. I couldn't do it. $100 is yours. Didn't have the elephant ear? We got the elephant ears. We just ran out of those big buns. Don't send Sabu in here. Yes, sir.
Mr. Sales. Mr. Soupy Sales?
Yes.
I am so full of thrill and happy to be meeting you in your face.
Well, thank you. Can I help you?
Oh, sir, it is my humble duty and heaven-sent wish to be helping and of service to you. You see, I am president of the Soupy Sales Fan Club.
Oh, thank you.
New Delhi, India chapter.
New Delhi, India? I never knew I had a fan club in India.
Oh, young sir, you are beloved there by myself and other aspiring Indian comedians there.
Comedians? My fan club in India is mostly comedians?
But yes, indeed. We are meeting every Saturday night in the Delhi, in New Delhi, where all the show folks are going for after work hot corned beef curry sandwiches. Yeah.
You meet where?
In New Delhi, in the New Delhi. It's a Delhi. You see, we are meeting there and talking of you, and we laugh and laugh at your lovely and funniness.
Well, that's great.
Oh, Mr. Sales, I am wondering if I could ask of you one thing. Mm-hmm. It would mean more to me than you could ever know.
What's that?
An autographed photo of yourself signed to me to show to the others in the club to prove you are a living man and not a legend in your own mind.
A legend? Oh, yes. Yeah, sure, you kid.
I'm so happy. I cannot wait to go back there. Oh, this is so great.
Yes. Oh, yes. I'd be happy to autograph the photo. What's your name?
My name is Van Karatam Darzubala Hemrajani Jr.
Could you repeat that?
I think so.
Yeah.
My name is Van Karatam Darzubala Hemrajani Jr.
How do you spell it?
My mother helps me.
Thank you for being with us. Have a nice evening. Great day tomorrow. Bye-bye, everybody.